Hey guys, it's me, Jerry. Welcome back to another episode of No Skunk Adventures. We're heading off to Lake McAlpine this morning, going after some lightning trout. Hopefully I'm able to get some good footage for you. Do me a favor, if you like the content, go ahead and like, comment, and subscribe. And we'll get the camera back on once we get a hookup.
There we go. Nope, came off.
That fish was momentarily hooked on a jerkbait. Okay, this is my setup for when I go trout fishing. I have a three-pole rod holder by Rod Runner, and I have it for three reasons. One, it helps keeps my poles and hooks tangle-free when I'm transporting them around the lake or along the creek. Two, it acts as a rod holder for my bait pole, although you got to be careful because if you get a strong fish, your rod holder and pole's gonna flip over, possibly go in the water. And lastly, for the poles I'm not using, keep them off the ground so I or other fishermen don't accidentally step on the rod. My first pole, I have a G. Loomis Trout Series rod, 6'7". Have 5-pound braided line with 4-pound fluorocarbon leader. I use this to fish mini jigs and swim baits, and I have it with a Stradic 1000 series reel. There we go. All right, no skunk. Hooked up on the mini jig. That was the hint. After I saw you get the second one, I said, you know what? I'm gonna go as close as possible to that. All right, thanks, Glenn.
Yeah, no problem. Nice one.
Yeah, good size one. Thank you. Board.
Here we go. Yeah. Perfect. He got stuck in his knees.
Last pole is also a Loomis bass rod drop shot E6X rod. I believe this is 6'10" and I use this for hard tackle like jerkbaits, spoons. This has 8 pound braid, and then again I believe this is 6 pound fluoro to help keep the line clear. And I have another Stratic rod on a Stratic reel, 2500 series. And
there we go. Oh, it came off.
Anytime I want to take a break, I just cover a Gamakatsu size 10 single leg hook with some power bait.
Bit, getting bit, little bitty. Lightning. Little power bait.
You got it?
Yeah.
Yes. I want to
purchase it. All right.
Fat one.
Okay, thank you. I'll be over.
Yeah, that's a fat one. Dirty, but nice pound plus.
My second rod is an old school G. Loomis IM6 7 foot rod, rated from 4 to 10 feet. This I have just, it looks like 6 pound mono throughout. Right now I have a sliding sinker, it's my bait pole. I have a Senko on it right now, but normally it's power bait or salmon eggs. And then to go along with the old school motif, I have a Daiwa BG10. You're casting all the way to the left. Fish on. Trouter hitting on the power bait. Yeah. Yeah, when I got here, there was one guy here that just limited it out, and I said, oh, I'll go around the lake once.
Yeah, no, there's a guy right, I've only been here for like an hour tops.
Yeah, I didn't see you here when I came in about, so that's why I said.
Need a net?
No, I think. Yeah, I've caught a few. go. Fish on. Fish on. On the rainbow. On the baby brown Sierra Slammer. Yes, I think I can get him. All right. All right, there you go. You can see there's a swim bait in its mouth. Oh, nice one. Lightning. This one's a nice one. These weeds. Again on the Sierra Slammer. Not a bad stringer for the day's effort. The 5-fish daily bag limit doesn't apply at Lake McAlpine. You can catch as many fish as you'd like. However, you'll be charged extra for anything over 4 pounds. All right, moment of truth. How much do these fish weigh? See the weight on this. £11. Hey guys, just finished another successful outing at Lake McAlpine. Ended up catching 6 trout. 3 were rainbows, 3 were lightning. Totaled 11 pounds. Caught them on the mini jig with the tail. I believe that's called the atomic teaser. Also got one on a jerk bait, a couple on power bait, and of course caught at least one on the Sierra Slammer swim bait. So do me a favor, if you like the content, give a like, comment, and subscribe. Stay safe out there. Until next time, no skunk.